You know, baking on Mother's Day is always super special because both my mom and I share the same love for baking and desserts. It's a baked blueberry cheesecake that I'm baking for her this year, and it's a very interesting eggless recipe that I also wanted to share with you. Let's get started. The first thing that we need for this recipe are 2.5 cups of crushed biscuits. I'm using digestive biscuits today. I'm going to add them into my blender and then process them until I get fine biscuit crumbs. This looks good, let's transfer this into a bowl. And into this, I am going in with 1/2 cup of salted butter that I've melted in the microwave. Let's give this a quick mix just to ensure that all the biscuit crumbs are nicely and evenly coated with the melted butter. Once your mixture resembles wet sand, you know it's done. And now this goes into the bottom of a 6-inch springform pan. I like to use my spatula to just press the biscuit crumbs tightly into an even layer. And this is what is going to form the base of our cheesecake. So our biscuit base is ready, and now this goes into the fridge for about 10 to 15 minutes, and meanwhile we can start working on the cream cheese filling. I'm using store-bought cream cheese today, but you could also make it at home from scratch. I'll leave the recipe link to that in the description box below. Otherwise, you could completely substitute the cream cheese and use 1.5 cups of hung curd, which will also give your cheesecake a super creamy texture. Now in a small bowl here, I'm going to combine 1/2 cup of heavy cream with 2 tablespoons of corn flour. This looks good, let's add it into the bowl with the cream cheese. Into this, I'm also going to add about 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. And to add that kick, 1/2 teaspoon of fresh lemon zest, which is the yellow skin of the lemon. And now one final ingredient for the filling, which is 1 cup of sweetened condensed milk. Now at this stage, your mixture may have a few lumps, but you could get rid of it by mixing it with a balloon whisk or processing the filling in a blender for a couple of seconds. This looks good, and it's now ready to go on top of our cool biscuit and butter base. Before I pop this in the oven, I also like to seal my springform pan with 2 layers of aluminium foils so that once it's baking, nothing goes out of the pan and nothing comes in. And as always, let's place the cheesecake pan in a bigger dish and fill it up with hot water up to 1 inch, which ensures that my cheesecake doesn't crack while it's baking in the oven. And now this goes into the preheated oven at 160 degrees Celsius for about 1 hour. My cheesecake is out of the oven and it's baked beautifully. What I like to do is run a knife around the edges carefully while the cheesecake is still warm so that I can release it from the pan. And now this goes into the fridge for about 4 to 6 hours to chill and set properly. While the cheesecake is chilling, let's get the work started on our topping. I'm making a blueberry topping today, but you could top your cheesecake with whatever you like. It could be chocolate ganache or mango puree or maybe even some fresh fruits. For the topping, I'm going to cook 2 cups of these frozen blueberries. With some sugar and some lemon juice. The sugar has melted completely. I'm now adding in a slurry that I've made by combining water and corn flour. I'm going to cook this filling until it comes to a slight boil. So my filling has become nice and thick, which means I can take it off the heat and let it cool completely. I love how delicious and creamy this cheesecake is, and the blueberry topping has that nice tartness which I really enjoy. I hope you guys will try this eggless blueberry cheesecake at home, and once you do, share pictures on Instagram by tagging me at Shivesh17. I'll see you guys very soon with another recipe. Until then, take care and be safe.